Well, personalized medicine improves the quality of life and reduces the healthcare costs. So these are the two main features and benefits of personalized medicine. Now, by using Bento Lab, you bring the benefits of personalized medicine even to remote areas. So you make personalized medicine affordable and applicable to the widest possible community.
We're interviewing scientists, pioneers, and Bento Lab users that are pushing the boundaries of accessible biotechnology. Today, we're exploring personalized medicine with Professor George Patrinos and Stavroula Siamoglu from the University of Patras. This video is brought to you by Bento Lab, a DNA analysis laboratory you can take anywhere. Hi both, it's so fantastic to be speaking to you. Thanks for joining me. George, could you explain to me what is personalized genomics?
I'm George Patrinos, I'm Professor of Pharmacogenomics and Pharmaceutical Biotechnology at the University of Patras, Department of Pharmacy. I also hold two adjunct positions, one at Erasmus University Medical Center in Rotterdam in the Netherlands, at the Department of Pathology, and also the United Arab Emirates University in Al Ain, Department of Pathology, the College of Medicine and Health Sciences. Also, since 2010, I'm Greece's national representative at the European Medicines Agency at the Pharmacogenomics Working Party. So personalized medicine, basically, is the means of exploiting a patient's or an individual's genetic profile to stratify therapeutic modalities or to predict the possibility of suffering from a disease, from the genetic disease. And the aim is not only to improve the quality of life of the patient, but also to reduce the overall healthcare expenditure. Because by minimizing adverse reactions or by maximizing the efficacy of the drug, then the patient improves the quality of life. He doesn't get any adverse drug reaction. That means he doesn't need to get hospitalized. So the overall costs for the hospitalization get diminished. And also his quality of life gets improved, which means that it also positively impacts on the healthcare costs.
What is the scientific approach that you're taking?
So it's a basic low-throughput molecular genetic approach that can be applicable on the Bento Lab. So we isolate the DNA from whole blood using a very standard approach that we have optimized in the lab. It takes roughly 30 to 40 minutes. And then you run a plain allele-specific PCR on the Bento Lab, and then you visualize the result with gel electrophoresis.
And who do you envisage being the end user?
The end user of this approach are cardiologists. They're physicians, they're not patients, because only physicians can adjust the dose based on the genetic profile of the patient. Only these professionals are knowledgeable to make this adjustment, not the patient, okay. Only the physician.
Stavroula, how did you get involved in the project?
Well, I've joined the Lab of Pharmacogenomics and Individualized Therapy for the last approximately 6 years. I started as a diploma student here, then I made my master's degree, and now I'm working on my PhD here in collaboration with the lab. And also I have to mention that I am the laboratory manager here for the last year. So I'm very pleased for the collaboration with Professor Patrinos, George Patrinos. We're working on many projects for the last 6 years, mainly based on pharmacogenomics. And the Bento Lab approach is an approach that we have started the last 3 years approximately. We started with education from students, from primary school to high school and colleges, of course, and trained the trainers also. And now we're working on the diagnostics field.
Stavroula, could you tell me a bit more about the educational project that you've been working on?
Our main goal is to make the audience, the public, familiarized with the linkage between phenotype and genotype, so as to understand more easily the connection that there is between the genotyping, the genetic profile, and the drug response or the possibilities that they have in order to have drug reactions, adverse drug reactions, I mean. So in order to make this much more easy for students and even to the trainers, we try to make them understand that they have a differential taste of bitter due to their genetic profile. For example, I taste the carrots much more bitter than you, or Professor Patrinos tastes it less bitter than me. That's why, and the reason back from that is that we have different genetic profile.
So people can connect their genetic profile in terms of taste to how they might respond to different medicines, also based on their genetics, and understand those links.
Exactly.
A big part of your work is also getting more people involved in personalised medicine. And this summer you're taking part in iGEM, the International Genetically Engineered Machine Competition for Students, which is actually where Bento Lab started. How has that been going?
So this year we're working on how we can make precision medicine more applicable to the public. It's a very important experience for all the team, and especially for me, working with all these amazing colleges. The competition, to be honest, is really demanding, and the competition between all the colleges all over the world is very important and extreme sometimes. But all the competition has main advantages for all of us, and it is very important to make science more applicable to the public.
How are you hoping that personalized medicine will develop?
To be honest, I'm very ambitious about the future of personalized medicine, but the truth is that we need all the people from all around the world and from different expertise to make significant efforts so as to make personalized medicine more applicable to the public.
Now, a question for both of you. What advice would you give to yourself when you were starting out as a young scientist?
They have to follow their dreams, no matter what obstacles they have to overcome. They have to be positive, and whatever efforts they may need to do, they don't have to quit.
I would use something that I posted this morning. Every failed experiment brings you closer to success.
That is a good one. How can people find out more about your work and follow your lab?
So we have a website, which is permed, from personalizedmedicine.upatras.gr. So this is our official laboratory website, where we describe the project we are undertaking in there. We try to keep it as updated as possible. It does work all the time, of course, you understand. And apart from that, we have our social media accounts. So, LinkedIn, mostly, and occasionally Twitter.
Well, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much. That was great. And thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much for the invitation.
It's been a pleasure being here and for discussing the project we're undertaking, especially with the Bento Lab.
You can find out more about George and Stavroula's work in the description below. And if you've got a question for them, leave a comment. If you enjoyed the video, give us a thumbs up and please support us by subscribing to our channel. Thanks, and see you again soon.